Welcome to the NRSNG show. This is John Hawes, RN, CCRN, and I'm so excited to welcome you here. We have a great show for you today. I know it's going to get some people upset. I know it's going to tick some people off, but I wanted to say some things, and I really hope it resonates with you, and I hope it helps you. You guys, if you need extra help with test taking, we actually created a webinar on test taking to help you with that. If you go to nrsng.com/test-taking, that's nrsng.com/test-taking, we have a webinar up there. It's about an hour long, and it goes through 11 steps to taking nursing school exams. These are some strategies, some tips, and it provides you with a little bit of critical thinking and kind of lets you inside the mind of these nursing school test writers, okay? So that's nrsng.com/test-taking. All right, guys, we'll see you in the show. Before I get rolling today, I want to throw out a little caveat. I want to say, first of all, that look, I have a deep respect for many nursing educators. I think there's nursing educators throughout the world who are doing just a phenomenal job educating nursing students, providing educational materials, instructing them, holding their hand, taking them along in this journey to become a nurse. And I consider what we do here at NRSNG obviously to be nursing education, and we have a team of nurses here that are doing such an incredible job educating and providing encouragement and helping you guys. But I also want to say, okay, here's the caveat part. So when I talk about nursing educators in this podcast, because I know I'm going to get going, I'm going to get ranting probably, that I want you to realize I'm talking about the system, okay? Like the system of nursing education, okay? The overarching kind of ideology behind it. I'm not talking about a specific nursing educator. If you are a nursing educator and you're listening to this podcast, I can already pretty much guarantee that you are one of the incredible nursing educators that are out there busting your butt every day educating nurses. So with that said, you guys, I want to talk about something today. You guys know that I have a tendency sometimes to get a little bit frustrated, a little bit upset when we get specific emails or when things happen. And so what I want to talk about, guys, is I want to just go on talking again today about the fact that nursing education has to change. It needs to change. Okay, as humans, we have this fundamental flaw. We're very susceptible as humans to cognitive biases. Now, what are cognitive biases? Basically, they are tendencies to think in certain ways that can lead to systematic deviations from a standard of rationality or good judgment. So that's the definition. Essentially, what it means is cognitive biases are things that can come in, tendencies that can happen to us, things that can occur that lead us to think poorly, to have poor judgment, or to stop thinking rationally. Now, there's literally hundreds of different kinds of cognitive biases, but I want to discuss just one and how it pertains to the glaring reality that nursing education has to change. The one I want to talk about is confirmation bias. Now, I'm sure you've heard of it before, and no doubt you've experienced it at one time or another, and the following definition of what it is comes from Psychology Today. So Psychology Today says confirmation bias occurs from the direct influence of desire on beliefs. When people would like a certain idea or concept to be true, they end up believing it to be true. They are motivated by wishful thinking. This error leads the individual to stop gathering information when the evidence gathered so far confirms the views, parentheses, prejudices, one would like to be true. And it continues, we embrace information that confirms that view while ignoring or rejecting information that casts doubt on it. Confirmation bias suggests that we don't perceive circumstances objectively. We pick out those bits of data that make us feel good because they confirm our prejudices. Thus, we become prisoners of our assumptions. Now, I like that last part, we become prisoners of our assumptions. In essence, once we've fallen into confirmation bias, there is no amount of evidence that will allow us to see the truth. Okay, so how does confirmation bias apply to nursing education? Now, before I say that, I want to say becoming a nurse educator is a very demanding task. Generally, the nurse educator at a college, at a nursing school, has worked several years, 3 to 5 at a minimum, on the floor as a nurse, after which they obtain an MSN, a Master of Science in Nursing degree, with a focus in education usually. This education usually comes with additional student debt beyond whatever they accrued in their undergraduate studies. Now, following all these years of education and experience, the new nurse educator begins teaching nursing students. They join the rank of nursing educators tasked with educating the new generation of nurses. But there's several problems facing nursing education right now, and I fear that some nursing educators, administrators, and colleges are turning a blind eye to the problems facing nursing education due to confirmation bias. Now, I understand this is going to make a lot of people mad as I start talking about this, but I want you to understand, and I want you to listen to the everything that I'm going to say. So, according to an AACN publication, the average age of nursing faculty was 56 years old. The average age of retirement for nursing educators was 62.5 years. There was a 12% shortfall in the number of available educators, and 56.5% of nursing schools said they were unable to find qualified applicants. Another study by the NLN, National League of Nursing, found that 42% of full-time and 39% of part-time nursing professors were older than 61 years old. There were also 1,072 nursing faculty vacancies, and 83% of nursing programs were seeking to hire new faculty. Now, the NLN also found that in BSN programs, only 18% of nursing students were over 30. So what I want you to see from there is kind of this contrast in the age of nursing professors and the age of nursing students. Okay, that's something that I believe can be a problem. Now, compound on that the fact that there's not enough nursing educators out there. So finding somebody that can teach you and that has experience and can connect with you is becoming increasingly difficult for nursing schools. This is a very difficult task and a very difficult problem that they're facing. So what is the problem? When we become part of a group, okay, nursing educators, for example, especially a group that is so underfunded and understaffed like nursing educators, it becomes very easy to defend every action and every individual. Now, this is flawed, however, because doing so denies the issues and neglects the need for change. Rather than keeping an open mind about how to improve, the moment we try to protect or defend an entire industry, we enter into confirmation bias and inhibit our ability to objectively see the need for change. Now, I know without a doubt that whenever I mention the need for change in nursing education, we will get an email or two from a professor or administrator ranting up and down saying some of the following things. Okay? And I'll tell you my response to some of these things. Now, this isn't how I respond. I respond more professionally, but I'm gonna tell you how I feel about some of these responses that we get. So if I mention the need for change in nursing education, one of the first responses we might get from a professor would be, how dare you say there are flaws in nursing education? Now, I promise you, we do get this from time to time. How dare you say things need to change? Here's how I feel. It's completely asinine to assume that there are no flaws in any industry, company, or individual. Hell yes, there's flaws in nursing education. You know that. You know what? Also, there are flaws in NRSNG, and there are flaws with John Haas, myself. None of us are perfect, and it's time to be a bit more humble about what needs to change. Another response we might get sometimes is, you are everything that is wrong with nursing. So they'll say that to me, you are what's wrong with nursing. If pointing out areas of improvement and then creating those lifelines for nursing students after the educators they have relied on have failed them is quote unquote what's wrong with nursing, then we have much bigger problems on our hands. Okay. Another response we might get is, if students weren't so lazy, ... No doubt. Look, there are some lazy students out there. However, all 300,000 nursing students are not lazy. Just like all nursing educators are not bad. Lazy students do not preclude the educator from educating. Just as poor educators do not preclude the nursing student from graduating. Okay? Another response we get sometimes is, we don't know the professor's side of the story. I'm sure you were in the wrong. Now, I'll send out an email every now and then that talks about when I dropped out of my, or withdrew from my nursing program, then went back to finish. And so they'll say this at that point, and I state exactly what I did wrong on that very post. Okay? Now, being willing to share my failure shouldn't grant you the right to attack my vulnerability and excuse poor education. The professor that I talk about in there was a terrible professor, hands down. I had some great ones. I had some really, really great ones. But this particular one was a horrid professor. Now, another one we get, and this is the one that ticks me off more than any other one, is nursing school was hard for me, so it should be hard for others. It's the school of hard knocks. Now, like I said, this one pisses me off more than any other one. Here's how I feel. Is this a joke? Like, seriously, is this a joke? It's your freaking job to educate. I would never wish on anyone to work on a floor where this mentality was adopted. Imagine working with nurses who think it's okay for other nurses to struggle just because they've had some hard shifts. Like, this has to be a joke. If you see a coworker struggling and you just turn your head and let them sink rather than throwing them a lifeline, you need to get over yourself. Okay, that's not what nursing's about. Nursing is about helping each other, rallying around each other to improve patient care. Developing this mentality already in nursing education that it was hard for me, so it needs to be hard for you, it's a school of hard knocks. No, like, just no. That is entirely wrong. Now, another one we've gotten from time to time, I think once we got this email, someone said, we will never share your materials with our students. Thanks. You just proved my point that nursing education needs to change. How juvenile it is to deny your students of helpful materials just because your feelings got hurt. The funniest thing about this email is that they are emailing us after finding and using our materials. Then they get their feelings hurt and refuse to distribute anything NRSNG to the students. Dude, like, you just proved the point. Some administrators have gone as far as to ban myself, John, from physically coming on their campuses. Come on, like, it's time to grow up. Recognize the flaws and provide your students with anything that will help them. If you're not one of these professors or you're not one of these administrators that is making nursing education more difficult for your students, then you're going to invite us onto your campus. You're going to use our materials because you're looking for these things. You're trying to make nursing education better. You're not one of those that's making it more difficult, okay? Now, you need to realize that your job as an educator is to help your students, all right? Now, here's another one we get. You're a bad example of negativity in nursing. Now, I take offense to this, okay? Our podcast has 800 plus episodes covering an enormous amount of materials on positivity. Our blog has over 800 posts. Our YouTube channel has 400 plus videos. Our Instagram account has 700 plus posts. And I could go on and on and on and on about all the things that we've created. Our books, our podcasts, our materials, our study materials. 99.9% of this material is positive to nursing and nursing education. If I point out one flaw or state once that nursing education needs to change, and you see that as negativity in nursing, I fear that, like, you're so deep into this confirmation bias that you can't see what needs to be done to improve this process. So here's the problem, guys. What happens, I think, as we join a group, as we become part of a group, we begin to take pride in being a part of that group. We start defending our group of people, career or team, educators, etc., to the point that we fail to see flaws. If you can't see the flaws, you become unable to see the need for improvement. You begin to defend your group regardless of what they do. They can do no wrong. They walk on water. Now, here's an example. At the risk of sounding political, and I really don't want to sound political, I'm just using this as an example. If you consider the Blue Lives movement in response to the Black Lives Matter movement, what we saw were two deeply entrenched groups unwilling to see a flaw with their own movement or group. In each of the cases, one side or both sides made mistakes. But the two competing groups had become so biased that they were unable to see any flaw on their own side. To say that no police officer ever made a mistake or acted in prejudice is just crazy. You simply can't defend an entire group or career field like that. It's impossible. Now, that is really dangerous. I would never state that every nurse is perfect, without flaw or even caring. Some nurses are just bad nurses. There are some that I would prefer not to work with. There are some who I think are unsafe nurses and should not be working in the field. There's 3.1 million nurses in the U.S. We're not all perfect. Now, that shouldn't surprise you. My fear is that some in nursing education have adopted this sentiment, circled around each other, buried their head in the sand, and are now attacking even the slightest mention that maybe, just maybe, they can improve. Instead, they're so focused on protecting their own that they're unable to see the need for change in nursing education. A top nursing education company that I won't mention pointed out some of the reasons that nursing students for nursing school attrition, which means nursing students drop out or leave nursing education. Now, in this paper, their goal was to identify why students drop out and how we can fix it. Now, here's what's really interesting about this paper, and here's what really bothers me about this paper, is in this paper, they pointed to the student, essentially, as the reason that the student fails out or drops out of nursing school. They pointed to things like emotional maturity. They pointed to things like poor grades. They pointed to other things like the student not feeling a part of the group, that this is why students are failing out of nursing school. What bothers me about this paper is that in these, you know, 12 pages or so of this paper, not once is the professor's teaching methods mentioned, or staff training mentioned, or student resources available for them, or stress management systems mentioned once in this paper. Instead, they're putting all the blame on nursing attrition on the student, rather than saying, okay, maybe there are some things that we can fix. Maybe we should train our staff better and teach them how to teach better. Maybe we should provide more resources for our students. Instead, they're putting all the blame on them. And now what I know from my experience and from talking to hundreds of thousands of nursing students around the world over the past several years is that, yes, these things matter. Like, you know, the student being prepared. But here's the thing. It's the nursing school's job to determine if a student's prepared to enter the program. And then once they're in, it's their job to teach the student. Okay, that's the job of a teacher, is to teach. Okay, so to put the blame entirely for attrition on the student is just wrong. Okay, that's just completely flawed. We have to look at what we can do as a nursing education system to improve it. Now, here's the thing. NRSNG would be out of business if nursing schools were doing what they were supposed to be doing without any problems. If students were being taught, supported, and encouraged as they should be, we'd be completely out on the streets. We'd have to close our doors. And that would be a great thing. I would love it if nursing students were being taught as they should. I would be ecstatic if NRSNG had to close its doors because nursing schools were doing their job. But you know what? That's not happening. Instead, we're growing exponentially. Students are loving us. NRSNG is becoming grassroots. Students love that not only are we calling to light what needs to change, but we're creating that change. Sadly, rather than being part of the change, some professors are getting their feelings hurt, deepening their confirmation bias, refusing to see the need to evaluate themselves, and deepening the void between themselves and their students. Now, as of March 2017, we've had 3.1 million podcast downloads, 200,000 social media followers, 160,000 blog subscribers, and 5.4 million website page views. Our customer service department has had to grow faster than any other part of NRSNG. We literally get hundreds of emails a day from students all around the world telling us that I saved their education. One person said, at NRSNG, just signed up and learned more in 13 minutes about diabetes than two lectures in class. So glad you guys are around. These are the types of emails that we get, like, I was struggling and then I found you guys. I was about to fail. I was failing out of my program. Made a 70, then I found you guys. You know, so without even meeting these students face to face, we're providing them with what they need to succeed. All right. Now, at the same time, we'll maybe get one email a month from a professor telling us how upset they are and how horrible we are. I try nicely to help them see that maybe it's time to reevaluate the way we teach nursing students. Now, here's a little bit my story. So what I've done with NRSNG from the very beginning was try to share my story. I didn't start out with any sort of vendetta, and I don't have any sort of vendetta against nursing schools. Believe it or not, I have a tremendous respect for nursing educators, but here's what happened. My story resonated. I simply told my story and it resonated. I realized very quickly that I wasn't the only one struggling pointlessly through nursing school. I respect that nursing education is difficult. I mean, learning how to care for a human in their most desperate time is tough. But the entire process had become overcomplicated and turned into an us versus them with professors. Calling that out and trying to create a lifeline for nursing students should not turn into a battle. Rather, educators, some, need to attempt to peel themselves away from their confirmation bias and see that, like, this is what I want them to see in their minds. Wow, these poor kids, these poor nursing students are really struggling. I mean, yeah, med-surg is hard, but should my students be struggling this much? You guys, nursing education has to change. Mainstream nursing education is not working. We're rushing kids through schools and leaving a trail of depression, broken dreams, and beat up students in the wake. To those schools, administrators, and educators who are searching humbly for ways to improve the system, thank you. We at NRSNG as educators must do our job. We must confront the biases and improve our systems. We must stay current, and above all, we must realize that nursing students are people. We need more nurses who give a damn. We have to stop burning students out. As educators, it's our job to educate. Some students are going to need that extra boost, that extra motivation, that extra hand-holding. Not everyone learns the same. Okay, we can improve this. We can change this. It doesn't have to be hard just for hard sake. All right, guys. If you need any extra help, please email us. Please reach out to us. Contact at nrsng.com. We're here to help you. We want you to succeed. That's our whole mission. Our whole goal is to give you the tools and the confidence that you need to succeed in nursing school, on the NCLEX, and in your life as a nurse. All right, guys, I want you to go out and be your best self today. Happy nursing.